hear me now, thou bleak and unbearable world. Thou art base and debauched as can be. And the knight, with his banners all bravely unfurled, now hurls down his gauntlet to thee. I am I, Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha. My destiny calls and I go. And the wild winds of fortune will carry me onward, oh, whithersoever they blow. Whithersoever they blow. Onward to glory I go.
I'm Sancho, yes, I'm Sancho. I'll follow my master till the end. I'll tell all the world proudly I'm his squire, I'm his friend.
Hear me, heathens and wizards and serpents of sin, all your dastardly doings are past. What a holy endeavor.
Well, oh, sun's in my ass, in your ass. Well, paddlers, looks like the tide's dropped a bit. Not much, but it's definitely dropped a bit, because them boats, which you'll see in a minute, I'll turn around again. Right. I was actually behind them the other day. Now, yeah, it was a nice little adventures and stuff while it lasted, but I really hope that this tide drops, because apparently the pub up there at Tickton, right, got flooded. It overflooded the other day, right, which is horrible for them. Not to mention all the boats, there's a lot of boats that are sank. But the tide's still high. You know that bridge over there, I still can't get under it, I'm still sort of like inches away. But it has dropped quite a bit, because them boats behind me, right, especially that one there, I was about 7 foot on the other side of it the other day. Right, so yeah. Anyway, I've got a new toy I'm just trying out. It won't be a regular thing. It's just something I wanted to have a play with. And I'll probably use it on my X500. Right, because it'll fit my X500 fine. And it'll be nice just for a little cruising. I'll see if you can show you it from this angle. How much of that you could see. I'll give you a closer look anyhow at the end of the video. Right, I'll even put some photos up, a quick 60 second video showing you it. But yeah, it's a motor that sits on top of your boat and it folds up and then folds down. It's a bit weird, and I'll tell you what, it's. I watched one or two videos. It's the cruiser motor. You can get them for paddle boards, all sorts of things. This is obviously the kayak design. I watched one or two videos and everyone seems to set them up on dry land. Lift the kayak up, put it on pods, as I call them. Lift the kayak up, set it all up, make sure it's all in the right position, everything. Then fold it up, put it in the water, then just drop it down whenever you want it. I wish I'd have done that. Messing about, I'd got it on the boat and then messing about trying to get it all lined up and everything. I nearly tipped. What I did was I went right into the shoreline and bumped against the shore, and you know what I mean. But yeah, like I said, it's only a bit of fun. It's not something I'm going to use all the time. Right? I'll probably enjoy it more in summer where you can just nice relaxing, go all the way to the end, because I know I've mentioned my shoulder a few times, I know. Right, but if I go all the way to the end, it's about 12 mile, and then it's 12 mile back. That's a hell of a paddle for my shoulder in one go. Right, in one go, that's a hell of a paddle. prefer it if you're stopping somewhat, but I've done it twice and I really, really felt it on my frigging collarbone. And I thought, I'm not doing that again. So it'd be nice for summer to do that. Yeah. Anyway, like I said, it's a bit of fun and I'll show you it later and catch you on the water a bit further down. Let's get going then. Wow. It's got 6 speeds. What that was, level 4. No way I'm going up to 5 or 6. I was actually worried about 4 because I thought I ain't got a skate on and that water was actually coming halfway up the boat. And I reckon 5, 6, you definitely want a skate on. And that's going against the tide. You get me? That's why I'm trying it now. I mean, I'm just going to paddle back as normal because I've got the tide with me. Right, in fact, it's blowing me back now. Yeah, but wow, that's got some speed. On level 1, right, it's so gentle and smooth and it's just relaxing. Right, and you paddle along with it, but you hardly feel your paddle because it just cuts through the water. Level 2 is basically the same but a little bit faster. Level 3, forget paddling. Right, by the time you put your paddle in the water, you need to lift it up. All you can do on level 3 is steer, which obviously goes the same for level 4. Level 5 and 6, right, I wouldn't, not unless I was in either the ocean or a huge, huge lake. Because it'll be going so fast, if you just veer up. Yeah, you've got an emergency cut-off switch, you've got a button you can press, you've got a kill switch, you've got a little tag. Right, I don't know if you can see it. Right, but if I pull that, right, it cuts the engine off completely. So there is lots of things to stop you from moving. Right, but the thing is, if you're going that fast, which you shouldn't be on a river anyhow, right, let's make one thing quite clear. It's got a 4 mile an hour speed limit, and I reckon there on level 3, right, if I remember rightly, level 3 is 6 mile an hour, so I was actually breaking the law then. Right, but I won't be doing it again. I just wanted to see. 1, it's in the middle of winter. 2, there is nobody about. Right, I just wanted to see what it was like on level 3 or 4. But I'll be sticking to level 1. Right, save battery. Right, so it's just pleasant. Not to mention, the more you turn it up, the more power you give it, the noisier the bloody motor is. And I won't want to put up with, say, level 3 or level 4 or whatever for more than a minute or two without earplugs. I put my earplugs in. But yeah, so I just wanted to give it a quick go, and I thought this area is the perfect thing. Nobody about. Middle of winter, so you know what I mean. Not going to disturb any wildlife because there's, well, the income. Right, while the tide's quite high, I thought I'm not worried about catching the motor now. Seeing tide high, I will mention it before I go. That pub we just passed, right, I told you the tide had dropped. You saw them seats outside, them garden seats. Right, well, the other day, the tide was so high and level with that wall behind it, I actually paddled around the back of them garden seats. I'm not the only one either. A guy called Bob. Right. He did the same thing. Right. But yeah, so that's how high it was, but it's dropped. It has dropped considerably. It's still, I mean, joking apart, if this was my first paddle of the year, I'd say, God, this is bloody high. But because I've already been out a few times and seen it even higher, you know what I mean? It's just a case of it's gone down a lot. All right then, yeah. I won't come back again, but at the end of the video, I was going to do like a description thing about this motor. I doubt any of you want one. Like I said, I got it for a bit of fun. Right, but I will be using it again. Right, but like I said, summertime. And I reckon this would be great on my X500. Right, Patrick will not approve. It's funny, I said to him yesterday in a comment. I said, I'm trying out a new toy tomorrow, but you will not approve. I'll be wrong now, he'll say, I love it, I want one. Yeah, it's the Cruiser thrust motor. If I remember, I'll leave a link in the description. But what I'll do is, instead of shoving something on at the end and stuff, because I know, and I don't mind, right, but I know a lot of you just skip my videos. They might watch a minute at the beginning and then skip to the middle and skip to the end, because I know some of them do go on for a long time. Fair enough, I understand. Bloody watch the full thing, or I'll come round to your... I'm joking. I understand that people want to skip videos and jump to bits, that's fair enough. Yeah, but what I'll do is I'll do a separate video. And I'll just do like a 5-minute video showing you it in the box. And then you've seen it on the boat. And then just telling you what you get, where to get it from, and the price. Yeah. And the funny thing is, and I think it's the price point, right? There's not many videos on YouTube about these motors. There's a few from the manufacturer. There's about 10 from the manufacturer, which I was glad of, because it's sort of like, even though you get a fantastic instruction book, it sort of like helps me in how to set it up watching the videos. But yeah. Anyway, I'll do that on a separate video. Well, paddlers, I had that motor in the wrong position. It wasn't completely flat. Right, now I knew that when I started, that it wasn't completely flat. Right, but I thought it was just because of the shape of my boat. Right, but no, it's because I had, there's like two locking braces, because I had the left one in the wrong position. Right. It wasn't flat. Well, the bottom line is, now I've got it flat, the motor is more under the kayak and you can't hear it. You'll probably hear it on number 4, 5, 6 or whatever, but on number 1, 2 you can't hear it. Not to mention it tracks a lot better now, which makes sense because the motor's further up. The motor is basically there under the boat now, right, so it's bound to track better. But yeah, I had it slightly in the wrong place, but I've been enjoying it, and I will use it again. Alright, don't get me wrong, it don't replace paddling, alright, but it's certainly nice in winter time. You can literally just put it on number one and just sit, relax, warm your hands up, and just, you know what I mean? I can see the uses for it, even in summer, occasionally, you get me? But yeah, it's nice. I mean, it's off at the moment, but on number one, it's just like a paddle assist. It's about, I don't know, maybe 1 mile an hour. Alright, so as you paddle with it, well, it just takes that strain off you. It's strange. Like I say, next time I go out on the water, I won't bring it. Alright, probably the time after that I won't bring it, but maybe the time after that, the third time round, I might bring it again. Alright, it's a gimmicky toy for me, right? Now I can see great uses for it though, especially in the sea and stuff, and especially if you're planning on going for a real long journey and you're alone, right? Having that in the back of your boat, right, is just an emergency. You don't know, you might break your arm or something like that while you're out, right? I can definitely see the uses for it. Anyway, let's get back to paddling. Well, I'll show you it first in the right position. That had to open it. So there, it's like flat now. I don't know if you can hear me, but that's with the motor turned on now. And now it's in the right position, it's a lot quieter.